Another picture perfect family. Should've known they kept bad company.
Welcome back, y'all. Today we are going to be doing what triplet is most likely to, and you may be asking, what do you mean by that?
What do you mean by that?
We asked you guys to submit us stuff on our Instagram. We said, what triplet is most likely to blank, example, crash a car, example, rob a bank, example, this. You guys sent us in stuff.
And we're gonna answer
it. We're gonna answer it right now. Dab me up.
Alright, and if you would like to possibly answer something you have asked,
go follow
our group Instagram account, because when we post stuff like this, you can
run it.
You know,
run it.
Participate.
Yeah. Run it. Which triplet is most likely to poison someone on accident?
Matt. Matt would be like, wash the dishes one day and add too much of like detergent or something.
Well, you don't, okay, like, so Chris, I'm
since
my
when
answer.
Have you ever put fucking
I'm
detergent
my answer
in,
to Chris.
In dishes?
Dish do my answer to Chris.
Dish soap, dish detergent, isn't that the same thing? Dish soap.
I'm changing my answer to Chris because Chris. That's the way he answered that question.
All right, whatever, bro. Next one.
Horrible.
What is that?
Be in a relationship.
Matt's my significant other.
I don't want a relationship because YouTube is my relationship.
Exactly.
I have a relationship with you guys.
Which triplet is most likely to survive a zombie apocalypse?
Okay. I know my answer to this question, like, super, like, pristine. I would not. I would die instantly.
Agreed.
Rather being, like, by a zombie or by my, like, you know, taking myself out.
Oh, I was like...
Because, you know, zombie apocalypse, like... At that point, honestly, there truly is not much left for you.
You know? Oh, yeah, for sure.
Like, I don't think... point, like, that's where I draw the line. Like, zombie apocalypse, have fun, y'all. Matt and Chris, on the other hand, it's an even battle. But the question is...
Cap.
Like, right now, it's even. Like, it's even. Like, right now, they could both equally survive. Matt has an energy drink. Matt is not only killing all the zombies, but is also killing Chris. And Matt will survive a zombie apocalypse. Alone.
Say that.
Off of energy drinks.
Say
if
that.
There's no energy drinks on the zombie apocalypse, they could probably handle
what's your
it
weapon of choice? See, my thing is, I would say, like, chainsaw, but it depends.
You don't have a battery.
That's what I'm saying. It depends on location. Do I got batteries? Do I not? Am I in a grocery store?
Weapon.
Like, where am I at in the zombie apocalypse? At a home, at a farm, at a
in
grocery store?
In our home city.
Yeah, it induces right now.
Like, it's it would
zombie
start
apocalypse,
right now.
Bang.
We're
right
driving
there.
To Home Depot. Getting all the battery packs, all the chainsaws. Then, from Home Depot, we're going to Wegmans and Dick's Sporting Goods. Baseball bats, because those are...
Wooden ones?
Fuck, doesn't matter. Wooden or metal, you're still getting hit in the dome. Head still popping off.
Yes, right, sir.
Next question. One.
I like that. Accidentally end up in Hawaii.
Go ahead, Matt.
Chris. You'd be in an airport trying to go to, like... fucking Georgia, for Christ's sake, and you'll just end up on the wrong plane.
No, Chris, literally, his sense of direction is the worst I've ever seen anyone's sense of direction ever.
Hold on, what did you
to
just
the
say?
Point where it's like,
run that back.
Anyone's sense.
What did you just say?
Chris's sense of direction is the worst sense of direction out of anyone I've ever met in my life, to the point where it's like we could go into a mall from like a parking garage and literally go into like the first store we see, and he will act like he was just like spawned in. Like, he has no
yeah.
But ironically, it's like stupid situations where he knows exactly where he's going. Like the other day we were in like the woods doing a photo shoot, and Chris is like, oh, I was like, oh, I don't know how to get out of the woods, and Chris was like, oh, I do, this way, and, like, takes me under a tree and, like, through a branch, and, like, we're back on the main path. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, it's, like, the stupidest shit like that. Like, Chris can't get easy places, but difficult places, oh, it's easy breezy.
Easy breezy. Cover girl.
Wrong.
Die first, LOL.
What is it?
I don't know.
What's the cover girl slogan?
Easy breezy beautiful?
Oh, that's it.
Okay.
Dad, what's the next one?
Die first.
Me.
Okay.
Sure. I'm out first. Gonzo.
Sure.
Why do I think I'm gonna
who's
die first?
Who's most likely to die
stupid.
In a horror movie?
Nick.
Nick is your average stupid.
Nick's the annoying one that does something
stupid
and just
that gets everyone in the movie pissed off.
Thank you.
All right.
Oh, no! Look!
Like the wannabe hero.
We should just go to the graveyard. That's a good thing. Like, you're the one that goes to the graveyard thinking nothing's wrong and then you die. Mm-hmm.
I feel like that's not true.
Yes, it is.
Or next to the person in the, like, the horror movie that has no idea what's going on, and everyone's like, oh, this person is out to get us. And he's like, no, he's not. That's totally fake. And ends up being the one getting scooped up first.
All right.
Gone.
Do you have any opinion?
No, not anymore.
Okay, good.
Better that way.
Mm-hmm.